How to have more freedom without going broke. Well, as you know, I've had a kind of a hard journey on my way to where I am today in building my portfolio. We almost went bankrupt at a point. But let me tell you a story about an acquaintance of mine. So this man is from Switzerland. He was going to invest in the UK, and he, let's just say, talked very big game. I introduced him to some people and they started doing some deals together. His thing was that he was very well connected and he was raising like massive amounts of finance. So he went out and bought like five different like supersized projects. We're talking developments of, converting houses or buildings into, 40 flats. And he's buying like five of these and looking at hotels in London and stuff like that. The guy just went all in and started doing some big things. Obviously, me being one of the ones who introduced him to some of my contacts, I'm kind of going like, wow, I should have charged more. This guy's insane. He's doing so well. What happened, though, and I learned this from one of my partners, is that he had gone into all these deals with the because his investor had promised him the money, but he didn't have any signed agreements. All of a sudden, Brexit happened, and a lot of the investors didn't put their money in. He'd already bought the buildings though. So now he sat there with five buildings that needed conversion and no money to pay for it. And his whole business just fell apart. Now, why am I telling you this story? This is a really depressing way to start your morning, and I'm sorry for that. Hey, thanks, Yaron. Thanks for that thumbs up. So why am I telling you this story? Well, because I want you to share with you that you don't have to rush in that fast to become financially free. Financial freedom can go quicker and easier than you could ever imagined, but you got to follow the tortoise, not the hare. Remember the race, the tortoise versus the hare? Slow and steady instead of, fast and crazy. Well, he went fast and crazy and it fell apart. I started out, remember, I built a £1 million portfolio in my first year, starting with about £1,000. Well, what happened? 3 years later, just a little after, like 6 months after my 1 year mark, I started going bankrupt. And luckily we turned it around. But it's slow and steady that wins the race when it comes to property every day of the week. Now, what is slow and steady? We call this, and we use a very powerful framework in momentum. We call it momentum investing. Momentum investing is about the power of building over time, okay? So bear with me now. Please, if you're there, leave a comment. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this as well. But what I want to share is momentum investing because it's very, very powerful how this will impact your investment future. All right. So what happens when you buy a property? Let's just use some numbers to make this as clear as possible. So say you buy a property for £100,000. Okay. So you have a £100,000 property. You then don't do anything. You just sit there with it. You're getting your passive income. You got your rent coming in, and then over time, it's going up in value. All right. So on average in the UK market, properties double in value over a 7 to 10 year period. So let's jump forward 10 years for this example. That means over 10 years, you've been getting cash flow, right? And you've probably been getting quite a lot of cash flow because you should be getting a return of, 10 to 15% per annum. So over 10 years, you've at least gotten all your money out in the form of cash flow. Well, what's even more exciting is the property has now doubled in value. It's now worth 200,000. All right. So, what can you do now? Well, if you had a mortgage on it, so say you just bought this property for 100K, you put 30K in, you got 70,000 pound mortgage. Well, over the 10 year period, you will have made. Good morning, Cecilia. How you doing? Say hi to your sister for me. So what would happen with these? Well, over the 10 years, your 30K would have come back in cash flow. Okay, so you got 30K, which is enough for another deposit, right? Hey, good morning, Alex. Thank you for being here. I know it's early Saturday morning, but hey, we're here, right? We're here, we're doing it. So we got that money coming in. Now the value's gone up by 100K. Your mortgage is still 70K. What could you now do? Well, you could go to the bank and say, "Look, I want to raise my lending to 60% loan to value." Initially, you had 70, so I'm saying lower your loan to value. But if you pull 60% of a 200K property, how much are you pulling? Exactly, 120,000. If you have a 70 mortgage, that means 50,000 pounds of cash. That means you've made 30,000 pounds of cash during the over in cash flow, at least, could be 45, plus another 50K in the cash out. What could you now do with this money? Yeah, you could use that as a deposit for another three properties. So what happened over this 10-year period? And you've probably done this during the process. I'm just jumping forward 10 years. You don't touch it for 10 years. But that means in 10 years, you use the equity and the cash flow from this property, and your property portfolio goes from one to four, just like that. Isn't that awesome? Now, what happens? Let's hop forward 10 years again. All right. So you got four properties now. They're worth 400,000 pounds in total. And you got, 70% loan to value, let's say, on that portfolio. So 400,000 was when you did the buy. So now, after 10, first 10 years, you bought four properties, total value. Well, the first one's doubled. So let's just say your property portfolio is worth 500K at this point. You got 70% loan to value. That's 350 pounds worth of mortgage. You've used your cash flow as a deposit. So now, hop forward another 10 years. Where are we now? Well, your portfolio has doubled in value again, right? That's a 1 million pound portfolio. What has happened cash flow wise? Well, over the last 10 years, because it's four properties, you will have made about 150K of cash flow, probably more, probably 200K, but let's use 150. All right, so you now have 150 pounds of 150,000 pounds of cash flow, but you also got 1 million pounds of value. Again, if we use, say, just say 50% loan to value. So we're lowering further. We've gone from 70 to 60 to 50. Now you got 50% loan to value. What's 50% of a million? 500,000, right? You had 350,000 in mortgage before. Where are you now? Well, that's another 150K out. That means now you've gone over a 20-year period, your lending has gone from 100% loan to value or 70% loan to value down to 50. But you now also have what are 300K in cash on which you can use as a deposit and buy another six. Well, actually, yeah, another six properties. And that's at 50% loan to value. Isn't that insane? So now, over a 20-year period, you bought one property once you put 30K into your business. And then you just sat and reinvested everything, took the equity and reinvested over a 20-year period without continuous, just once every 10 years you do something. It's now grown to 10 properties at a total value of almost 2 million pounds. Let that sink in for a moment. Over a 10-year period, 20-year period, one property with a 30K deposit, perfectly reinvested every 10 years, not continuously, which would have given you an even better return. You could be looking at a 2 million pound portfolio 20 years later. Isn't that insane? That's completely nuts. And say it doesn't go that well. Say it goes half as well. Well, you got a 1 million pound portfolio in 20 years. That's momentum investing. So instead of running around like my acquaintance there and trying to overextend and do something nuts, slow and steady wins the race. What if you bought two properties in the beginning there? Yeah, obviously it goes faster. But buy smart, buy good deals in good areas that will generate you income from day one. And start building your portfolio so that you can use that cash flow, use that equity to buy deal number two, and then deal number three, and then deal number four, and then deal number five, and it keeps growing. And it's like it's just self-perpetuating. That is property success, okay? That is how we build our portfolio. That is how you're going to become financially free. Not, it's not, property investing is not a get rich quick scheme. People talk about the no money down, the simple, the shortcuts, the easy. No, the real value is build a stable portfolio and then let it fund every dream you have. All right, so that's my lesson for today. So please comment. I'd love to hear your thoughts on the momentum investing method. It is so powerful. And I'd love to hear what you think. Thank you so much for joining me this morning, and I'll see you soon.